The building was conceived with the principles of innovation and engagement at its heart, and the idea was to connect our students, our researchers and our end users together in a creative and collaborative environment that really makes the exchange of ideas practical.
The major impact of M squared will be the availability of new functional space that will allow us to engage in a new broad range of collaborations. Over the next few years, we'll see a number of new projects initiated between the Ian Wark Research Institute and the Mawson Institute as we both habit this fantastic building.
This building in itself is built on the foundation of facilitating meeting between people. If you're a student, you can sit in a room doing an assignment on your computer and at the same time see the scientists out in the lab doing their job. It shows them the importance of collaboration.
We've designed and built into it laboratories with unique functionality that will allow us to become world leading in regenerative medicine.
Some of my research is focused at understanding how we can deliver drugs more effectively. We're developing new materials around nanoparticle coatings, and we're using these for the next generation of medicines.
My PhD topic is looking at using magnetic nanoparticles for detecting the earliest spread of cancer cells. We actually have collaboration with the Royal Adelaide Hospital, and so we're working with them in partnership to try and develop better contrast agents for detecting cancer cells.
The technology transfer node will allow us to embed researchers from industry and from small high-tech companies with inside the M squared.
What we are doing in this building is training the next generation of scientists and engineers together on projects that are multidisciplinary. Some of them are even working with industry to develop the latest technological advances.
The research I'll be undertaking here within the Mawson Institute and the M squared building is based on thin film coatings on plastics. These thin film coatings are thinner than a human hair, and they're going to be used in real world applications, such as the development of the world's first automotive plastic mirror.
Plastic mirror is a product. So actually, if you take a step back, it is really looking at where else we can apply thin film coating technologies. And that is actually now the foundation for the next 5 years of research that we've signed up to with UniSA and the Auto CRC.
I think we're building an atmosphere that all good universities aspire to. One where there's a real interplay between research and teaching. The university's new Bachelor of Science in Advanced Material is housed in this facility, and those students are benefiting greatly from this world-class environment.
It is a luxury to have the space that this campus provides for a new building. It's a building that's going to be intensely appreciated from all four sides.
Officially press the button.
We need to invest in our universities, in their teaching and their research and the connections with industry. This building does all of that, and I think it'll be a great asset for the University of South Australia and a great asset for the state.
We've got the Olympic Dam expansion, we've got unconventional gas, which is a whole new sector coming to South Australia, and we've got a burgeoning iron ore sector as well. All three of those groups have their own technical challenges, which the M squared centre is really in the box seat to help solve.
Our hypothesis is that by collaborating cross disciplines, that's the way to make a difference to the society.